Bacteria, viruses, and parasites are growing ever more resistant to the drugs that have been developed to combat them. In fact, this resistance, known as antimicrobial resistance, has surged into a public health nightmare around the world. In the US, antimicrobial resistance causes more than 2 million infections and 23,000 deaths per year. That's the equivalent of a Boeing 747 crashing each week. And annually, at least 700,000 people die from drug-resistant diseases, and that number is expected to increase to 10 million deaths per year by 2050 if nothing is done. Unfortunately, at present, the incentives to get something done are so misaligned that those 10 million deaths per year from antimicrobial resistance is a frightening possibility. Be sure to click subscribe and get your weekly updates on public health. Hello, and welcome back to Health and Human Rights Strategies YouTube channel. I'm Nicole Fisher, the founder of HHR Strategies. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says that antibiotic resistance is one of the greatest public health challenges of our time. And sadly, there is no slowdown in sight as more and more antibiotics lose their effectiveness each year. Financially, it's projected that due to lost wages, hospital stays, and premature death, the United States loses about $35 billion a year to antibiotic-resistant infections. So why aren't more pharmaceutical companies, or research institutions, medical centers, or government agencies doing something about the growing crisis? Sadly, there are multiple reasons that are all working in tandem. First, hospitals are a breeding ground for antibiotic-resistant bacteria. Because antimicrobials vary from antibiotics to antivirals to antifungals and antimalarials, understanding what they do can be hard for any layperson or medical professional. Additionally, the broad range of antimicrobials make prescribing them incorrectly very easy for health providers. Further, you have to remember that doctors are incentivized to use the cheapest generic drugs available within their hospital. And it's the overuse of these drugs that drives increased resistance. Think about how newer branded drugs cost more. They're also less known, and they're not readily available in databases or the electronic health records that hospitals use. Therefore, it's not easy for providers to learn about the impact, or lack thereof, of those drugs currently prescribed. Therefore, within just miles from each other, people can have wildly different resistant profiles. Add in that global policy challenges are developing all over the world. For example, in low-income countries. Countries like India make a lot of generic antibiotics, and the excess sometimes gets pumped into rivers. So all those people are drinking water and consuming antimicrobials. That's a great way to end up with multi-drug resistant bugs. But currently, there's something that's more frightening than exposure and a major challenge. And that's that there's a lack of research and development in pharmaceutical pipelines. As the private sector is honestly financially disincentivized to create new antibiotics, think about how quickly things mutate or how much it costs just to keep up. And it's pretty easy to see why there isn't a financial motivation for large pharma companies to invest in antimicrobials. This is further exacerbated by big pharma exiting from the market. In fact, there are only a few of the top 50 drug companies in the world who still work in developing antimicrobials. Clearly, the models for creating and distributing antimicrobials and the market failures that got us to the status quo have to change. And they have to change quickly. This could mean growing the conversation around extension of drug exclusivity. So what that means is for drug makers, instead of the present 5-year market exclusivity or patent that's associated with developing a new chemical, companies could get a longer patent to help ensure that they can see their product go to market and recoup some of those research and development costs. Public-private partnerships are another great way to potentially offset risk, and there's a lot of risk associated with this kind of research. The medical community, globally, also has to get better at understanding the implications of their dissemination of antimicrobials. And all of this has to happen before it's too late.